Welcome, everyone, and we're live from Benedictine University, where we have a big matchup between the Chicago Chaos and the Madison Wolves. We're going to send it right down to Jen Liner on the side.
All right, Jen, we're going to Jen in 3, 2, 1, go. Rosa, Hector, go on Jen. Hector, go on to Jen. Camera on Jen. Go. She turned up.
Wolves, I am standing here right now with number 70, Robert. He is our starting offensive lineman. How are you feeling about tonight's game?
I'm feeling pretty good, confident. We need a big win here.
All right, yeah, you guys, you know, did a really good job last Friday. You guys defeated the Thunder. It was pretty great.
It was a big game. You know, it was a huge win with a crossover matchup with a different league. Revenge from last year's game where we were kind of robbed. So good statement win for us.
All right, well, let's see how tonight's game goes. Good night, or good luck. Sorry about that.
Thank you very much.
Alrighty, thank you, Jen. All right, looks like we're about to get started here, folks. Like I said, we have a big matchup here in the GFL. We got the Madison Wolves at 4-1, and then your Chicago Chaos at 3-2. At a midway point in the season, this is going to be a big game in determining the playoff standings. Looks like Madison Wolves here are going to be kicking it off to your Chicago Chaos. So on offense, you're going to be wanting to look at some few key players here, like quarterback Michael Shuchuk, big dual threat player. He leads the team in rushing as well as passing. You'll also be wanting to look at receivers Matthew Brockman. And the kickoff gets returned to about the 38-yard line, where the Chicago Chaos will be taking over on offense. And returning the kick was number 23, Deshaun Sutton. And now the Chaos are going to start up on offense, and we'll have your lineup here. We have at quarterback, we have Michael Shuchuk, who I just mentioned a moment ago. At running back, you're going to have Jarrell Johnson. Your wide receivers are going to be James Former, Matt Brockman, Lucius Shanklin, and Deshaun Sutton, who just returned the opening kick. And the Chaos are lining up with about 14 minutes left in the first quarter. The line gets set. And looks like it's going to be a run play to Johnson on the first play. He gets through the line for a short gain of about 2. So we're looking at 2nd and 8 here on the first drive of the game.
The run for a short gain of 3.
I'm sorry, looks like it's going to be set up at the 41-yard line, so it's going to get a 3 on first down.
Chaos.
Now, some other key points to look out for. With the Madison Wolves, they are a big home run threat on offense. Their quarterback is a big deep ball guy. In terms of running, they do tend to rely on Antoine Anderson quite a bit. So it looks like we're going to have to keep an eye on him when the Wolves are on offense. They run it again with Johnson. Looks like he gets up to around the 45-yard line there. And it looks like it's going to be about 3rd and 2 here.
3rd and 2 for the Chaos.
Getting lined up here on a big 3rd and 2 here on the opening drive. And it's a handoff. Gets to the edge and he's down at around midfield. So it looks like the Chaos are going to get a first down here.
Number 6, the ball carrier. Good for a 4-yard run. 1st and 10 for the Chaos inside Wolves territory.
And that was James Former on the wide receiver sweep. On defense, a couple key guys that the the offensive line is going to want to look out for is definitely Adam Wedig, who has around 4.5 sacks so far this year. He's one of their biggest pass threats on the defensive end. So if they can contain them, the run game will continue to do well and hopefully open up the passing game. Informer is in motion, sets to the right. And the ball sails wide, so it looks like it's going to be 2nd and 10 here.
Chuchuk's pass, incomplete. 2nd down and 10 for
Let's
the Chaos.
Check out the replay there. Ball just sails a little wide. Now 2nd and 10, the Chaos line up here for the snap. Looks like it's a bubble screen over to Former. Short gang here is read fairly well by the Wolves. It's going to be 3rd and long here coming up.
Pass completed to Former. 2-yard gain brings up 3rd down. At 8.
Big 3rd down here for the Chaos. They're in what most people like to call no man's land. It's a bit out of field goal range, and it's a tough position to kick a or to punt from because they are on the other team's side of the field. So hopefully they're able to get a good chunk of yardage or even get the 1st down here on 3rd and long. And the snap goes to Shuchuk. And the pass is long outright. So it looks like it's going to be 4th down here for the Chaos.
Shuchuk's pass goes incomplete. Bring up 4th and 8 for the Chaos.
And looks like they are going to get ready to punt over to the Wolves here. The snap's good. The punt is away. And it looks like it's going to be returned by the Wolves. He finds a seam up in the middle of the field, and he's breaking free. And he's down just around midfield.
The punt brought back by number 85.
Poor kick coverage there by the Chaos.
They Chaos,
overcommitted to that left side and allowed the kick returner to send it up towards the middle field where he found a seam. So it looks like we're going to get a first look here at the Chaos on defense. Wolves line up. And they do a short pass to number 84 on the curl route. So it looks like it's going to be around 2nd and 5.
Bringing up 2nd down and 6 for the Wolves.
All right. Hand off up the middle. The running back breaks a tackle or so, and he's able to get a couple yards out of the play. So it's going to be 3rd and short here for the Wolves. One thing the Wolves are going to want to take advantage, or the Chaos are going to want to take advantage of, is the inconsistency with the quarterback play. The quarterback's completion rating under 50% on the season. And they go for a 3rd down run play, and it's looking like it might be just short of a 1st down. Great defense there by the front 7 of the Chaos.
Short gain on the run. Bring up 4th.
You can see there's great penetration by number 7 on the defense, allowing slowing up the running back just enough for his teammates to swallow him up just in front of the 1st down marker. So we have 4th and short here at the 40-yard line. Looks like the Wolves are going to go for it here. And it's a quarterback keeper. And he gets to about the 38-yard line, so it's looking like maybe enough for first down here.
Quarterback keeper for 1 yard gives the Bulls first and 10 from the Chaos 39.
And you can see here number one just missed a shoestring tackle on the quarterback to keep him behind the line, but it was just quarterback was able to high step it and get to the first down. Snap here, he rolls out to the right, and the throw is long here. So an incomplete pass brings up second and two here for the Chaos on defense.
Second down and 10 for the Wolves.
Some guys to keep an eye on the Chaos defense is going to be number 90, Chevy Jenkins, who's leading the team with 5 sacks on the season. He's going to be a key player in pressuring that quarterback into those wild throws and continuing his inconsistencies. So we have second and 10 here. About 7:20 left in the first quarter. First drive of the game for the Wolves. And the front seven of the Chaos again is able to slow down the run game for a short gain. May have been a gain of nothing. So we're going to have a third and long here. The play was blown dead before the fumble. So it is going to be retained by the Wolves.
Gain of one on the play.
Chaos doing a great job so far of slowing down that running game, which has been a key factor for these Wolves in their 4-1 start. And they go for a deep ball on the third down.
Oh.
It was juggled, and it looks like he did not keep... They're going to signal a touchdown. Looked to me as if the receiver juggled the ball before he, as he went out of bounds. Let's take a look at that again. See, the quarterback rolls out right. All right, so it looks like the Wolves are going to line up for two here. Rolls out to the right. He's able to sling it in for the two-point conversion. So it looks like it's going to be an 8-0 lead here for the Wolves.
With a two-point conversion, that gives the Wolves 8.
Unfortunate start for the Chaos. It did look like that receiver was not able to hold on to the ball before he was out of bounds. And that's something that the Chaos are definitely have to look out for with these Wolves. They do like to play the deep ball, and that could be a reason for the inconsistencies in the passing game. So after that touchdown, it's 8-0 Wolves here. 6.5 left in the first. And the Wolves are going to get ready to line up for the kickoff. So one of my main points I wanted to see from the Chaos today was to keep that running game in check, because it has been such a focal point in the Wolves' offense. Antoine Anderson does get a fairly heavy workload with the Wolves, and they did a great job on that first drive of keeping that in check. Kick is away, and it's fielded about the 10-yard line by Sutton. And looks like he's going to be down around the 28-yard line. I'm sorry. By former
29-yard line of the Chaos. First and 10 for the
Chaos.
So
it's like
from their own 29-yard line.
The officials are going to line up at about the 29-yard line. So with their first drive ending in an unfortunate punt in Wolves territory, let's hope that the Chaos' passing game will be a little more in sync this time around. As Shuchug missed a couple passes, it looked like he fired a bit early. First down, they give a handoff to to Johnson, and he breaks away. There was a flag on the play. He keeps dodging his tacklers, and he's going to get all the way down to about the 30-yard line. It's looking like this might be getting waved off here by the penalty.
To the 30-yard line, but there's a flag on the play.
And there was a holding on the play, so it looks like that play is going to get called back. Another unfortunate setback here for the Chaos. Right, so it looks like the Chaos here are going to get set for first and 20 now after the holding penalty on the breakaway run by Johnson. They got two receivers out to the right. It looks like they're going to hand it off again to Johnson. He doesn't find very much space in the middle of the field, and it looks like he's going to get just a gain of one.
4-yard gain. Bring up second down and 25.
I'm sorry, a gain of four. So we're going to have a second and 25 here for the Chaos. Chaos making it clear right away that they want to focus on the run game and break down that Wolves defense. And they're going to line up here for second and 25. They fake the wide receiver sweep. Shuchuk goes out to the left, and it was read well again by the Wolves, so it looks like it's going to be no gain on the screen play. So third and long coming up here for the Wolves. Let's see if they decide to test out the secondary here
of
the Wolves.
Bring up third down
and see if they can get a big first down here. If not, they will have to end up giving the ball back to the Wolves, who scored on that big pass play on third down. And they line up here with three receivers out to the right. Shuchuk rolls out to the right. He airs it out down the right sideline to Brockman, and it is just out of bounds. Just out of the reach of Brockman.
Incomplete.
So it is going to be fourth down here and 25 for the Chaos. Good route there by Brockman, and a nice throw by Shuchuk, just a bit out of reach there on the sideline. So now the Chaos are getting lined up to punt the ball away here. We've got about 2:45 left in the first quarter. Chaos are down 8-0 after a long touchdown by the Wolves. Oh. And it's a high punt shank to the right side, and it's going to go out of bounds at the Chaos's own 40. Poor punt there is going to give the Wolves great field position. So the Wolves line up with a single back out to the right. Quarterback's in the shotgun, and he rolls right. He tries to throw it in the middle of the field, and it's caught. Receiver's taken down at about the 18-yard line. So that's going to be a first down for the Wolves.
For the Wolves.
Chaos with his own defense, 18. And the receiver of the Wolves looks like he was able to find the hole right in the middle of them and was able to hang on to the catch after three Chaos players were bearing down on him. So the Wolves at first and 10. They're lining up here again, single back out behind the quarterback. Looks like he's lining up to the left. And it's going to be a draw by the running back. And again, the Chaos were able to stuff it at the line of scrimmage. Gain of 1 on the play for the Wolves. So we're going to have a 2nd and 9 coming up. That's the way the quarterback's looking left. And it looks like it was a miscommunication on defense by the Chaos. The Wolves receiver was able to get free and make it into the end zone for a touchdown.
That pass complete the end zone for a Wolves touchdown.
All right, and the Wolves are going to line up again for 2. Quarterback's looking left again. Short pass is dropped. So it looks like it is going to be a failed 2-point conversion, meaning the lead is just going to be 14 with 1:03 left here in the first.
Pass is incomplete. Which gives us a score of the Wolves 14, the Chaos nothing.
Once again, we'd like to thank all of you who are watching us on SportsTownChicago.com. We're live from Benedictine University. The Chicago Chaos are down 14-0 to the Madison Wolves right now. And the Wolves are lining up here, set to kick it away once again to the Chaos. Kick is away, and it's going to be fielded at about the 5-yard line. He leads left with it. He doesn't have a blocker. He runs out of room, and he's out of bounds at about the 22-yard line.
Number 23, the ball carrier.
So with 56 seconds left here in the first, the Chaos are headed out on the field for the third attempt at scoring here. So some takeaways so far from this first quarter. The running game has been fairly effective here for the Chaos. Their passing game has just seemed a little bit out of sync. Just a little bit of mistiming on each of the throws that have been down the field so far. If they can start connecting on some of those, I see the offense being a lot more productive here as the game goes on. And Shuchuk keeps it. And it's read well again by the Wolves defense. And he's going to have about a gain of 1 yard.
Loss of 1. 2nd down and 11 for the Chaos.
And that's going to be it for the first quarter. So we're going to take a short break here, and we will see you guys back here shortly with the start of the second quarter.
The Illinois Center for Broadcasting is now the Illinois Media School. We've been an institution in the Chicagoland area now for 30 years. Because the broadcasting world is always changing, so are we. Not only are we teaching radio and television production, but now you can learn all aspects of the media industry, like web design. You can even specialize in TV or film, sports broadcasting, and even sales. No matter where you are in the Chicagoland area, we have a campus near you. The Illinois Media School. Be on TV, be on radio, beonair.com. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting is now the Illinois Media School. We've been an institution in the Chicagoland area now for 30 years. Because the broadcasting world is always changing, so are we. Not only are we teaching radio and television production, but now you can learn all aspects of the media industry, like web design. You can even specialize in TV or film, sports broadcasting, and even sales. No matter where you are in the Chicagoland area, we have a campus near you. The Illinois Media School. Be on TV, be on radio, beonair.com.
All right, and we are back here at Benedictine University, second down 11 for the Chaos. They go deep down the field, and it is defended well by the Wolves. It looks like it's going to be an incomplete pass, and it's third and 11 for the Chaos. And while we have a moment, a special thank you to the Lyle Veterans Memorial. Their goal is to construct a memorial that honors our veterans while at the same time promotes civic pride. The memorial is to honor veterans that have served or are currently serving in any of the five branches of the military. This includes the Army, Navy, Marines, Air Force, and U.S. Coast Guard. Getting ready for a third and long here to start the second quarter for the Chaos. Shuchuk back in the shotgun. Johnson to his left. They do a fake handoff, and they do an out route to the left side, and it looks like it's going to be dropped, and it's going to be another fourth down here for the Chaos.
Number five, incomplete. Bring up fourth down for the Chaos on their own 21-yard line.
An unfortunate start here for the Chaos as they're getting ready to punt for the third time again. And it's looking like their offense has just been a little bit out of sync. Each pass has been, barring that last one, each pass has been a little off target. Shuchuk looking like he's a little bit off on each of his passes. It looks like they, I feel if they were to mix it up a little bit better with the running game, I feel it'll open up some holes in the defense. So the kick's going to be away, and it's another high and short punt. It's going to take a friendly bounce here for the Wolves, and it's going to be fielded without a fair catch. And the Chaos cover it well, so it looks like the Wolves are going to be starting on their own 41-yard line. As you can see, it was another high punt. It was looking like it was going to be another short punt that would give them good field position. But it took a friendly bounce, and the Chaos were able to cover the punt very well, with three players jumping onto him immediately after fielding it. And it's going to be handoff from the shotgun. Running back is going to make it up to about the 45-yard line. The Wolves getting good push on that play, giving their ball carrier enough space to get up down the field fairly well. So it's going to be a second and about four here for the Chaos. Quarterback in the shotgun once again. And it's a short pass to the right, and it's going to be complete to number 85. So it's going to be another first down here for the Wolves.
That pass complete inside Chaos territory to the 46-yard line of the Chaos. First and 10 for the Wolves.
Here once again in Chaos territory. Chaos need to start slowing down that passing game of the Wolves. They have done a great job with the run game so far, which is why the Wolves have switched to the passing game. Pass down the field. It was covered well, and it was caught. The ball was tipped by the Chaos defender, but the Wolves receiver was able to keep concentration on the ball and reel it in for another deep play.
To the 6-yard line.
You can see there, great concentration by the Wolves receiver, and it's going to be first and goal from about the 6-yard line here of the Chaos. And they hand the ball off. There's a big seam that closed up quickly in the middle. And it looks like it's going to be second and goal here from the Chaos's 2-yard line.
Second and goal from the 3.
The Wolves back in the shotgun here. He takes a snap. He's looking down the middle of the field, and it's going to be completed for a touchdown.
The pass complete for a Wolves touchdown.
The Wolves passing game has opened up quite a bit here after they were struggling with the run game and has led to 3 consecutive scores to start the game here. So with 11:42 in the second quarter, the Wolves are going to be up 20-0 so far. And it looks like then they are going to go for 2. He takes a snap. The quarterback's rolling right. He tries to float it towards the back of the end zone, and it's going to be incomplete. So it looks like the Wolves are going to fail another 2-point conversion attempt, keeping the lead to 20.
Leaves the score at the Wolves 20. The Chaos, nothing.
So once again, the Chaos are having a hard time with that deep ball threat that the Wolves bring to the table. They are doing a great job of reading the run plays well. And while we're waiting, we just want to take a second to appreciate the sponsor for our broadcast tonight. The Wolves are getting ready to set up for another kickoff from the 35. Kick is away. It's going to be a short one that's fielded at about the 16-yard line. He's going to head towards the middle, and it looks like there's going to be a seam. He loses the football. And it looks like the Wolves may have fallen on it. And they do. Number 34 of the Wolves is able to field recover the fumble. So the ball is going to go back to the Wolves on the Chaos's 45-yard line. And on a night where things seem to be going wrong for the Chaos, things get worse as their one bright spot of the game turns into a turnover.
Kick return fumble recovered by the Wolves. First and 10 for the Wolves.
So we have first and 10 for the Wolves from the 46-yard line of the Chaos. Quarterback goes from the shotgun. He dumps it off to his running back, who has room on the left side. And he's going to be taken down close to the first down marker. Whoops. All right, so first and 10 here from about the 37-yard line of the Chaos. The Wolves seeming to find all of the answers to this Chaos defense. And that was something that was well known ahead of the game, as they're leading the league in point differential. So you know they have a high-powered offense and they have a quality defense. That is why they are on top of the NFC division at 4-1. They have a short run play by the quarterback. And it looks like it's going to be called back by a hold penalty. So a good break there for
pushes them back
the Chaos
to the 46-yard line.
And so it's going to be second down from the 46-yard line. Quarterback looks right, and he dumps it off to the running back once again. But this time the Chaos read it fairly well. ball carrier makes a couple of tackles, and he's able to work the ball down to the 41-yard line of the Chaos.
4-yard gain.
You can see from the replay here,
for the Wolves.
Number three,
6 yards.
Resilient in his yards after catch. He's able to break a couple of tackles and get those extra yardage to bring up a 3rd and 6 here for the Wolves. Quarterback drops back, and it looks like they find a hole in the left side of the zone, and they're able to get another first down here.
Chaos 29, giving the Wolves 1st and 10.
So it's going to be 1st and 10 for the Wolves from the 29 of the Chaos now, as the Chaos seem unable to find answers to defending this pass attack from the Wolves.
Timeout, Chaos.
Timeout called by the Chaos here. Hopefully they're able to regroup and re-energize this defense and they're getting some stops here. Okay, and while we have a short moment, we'd like to thank our sponsors, the Lyle Wine Extravaganza. Wine aficionados will experience 10 one-ounce tastes of wine from a vast selection of over 80 different varieties of wine. There will also be craft beers to sample. The festival will feature live music from Tres Mustache and food from some of the local area restaurants. The La Wine Extravaganza will be on June 18th, 2016 from 4 to 8 p.m. at Museums at Lyle Station Park. For more information, please visit www.lyleschamber.com. And the Wolves are going to line up here for 1st and 10 from the 29 of the Chaos with 10 minutes left here in the half. They drop back. Chaos get good pressure. Ball is tipped in the air, and the safety for the Chaos is unable to corral it in. So
Wolves
it's going to
pass,
be
tipped, falls incomplete.
2nd and 10 here.
2nd down and 10 for the Wolves.
A great job by that front four of the Chaos to finally get some pressure on the quarterback and get him to hurry a throw. And that is going to be a big key here to slowing down this Wolves attack. Second and 10, they go for a run play down the middle of the field. It's read fairly well by the Chaos, and it's just going to be a short gain here on the play. So we're going to go 3rd and long
with the run
for the Wolves.
3rd down and 9.
So it's looking as though the Chaos coaching staff were able to get their defense to brighten up a little bit here, and we have a 3rd and 9 in store for the Wolves. And the throw is long by the Wolves quarterback, so it looks like it is going to be 4th down for the Wolves.
Bring up a 4th and 9 for the Wolves.
And a great turnaround here by the Chaos defense, who are looking a bit lost on the pass plays of the Wolves. They do a great job of regrouping, getting their communication down, and forcing a 4th down here. So it's 4th and 9 from the 28-yard line, and it looks like the Wolves are going to go for it instead of taking the 3 points. And the quarterback takes the snap. He rolls out right. And it's tipped by number 31 on the defense for the Chaos.
By the Chaos.
And it is going to be a turnover on downs here for the Chaos. Great play by the defense. And you can see here, read very well by number 33. He was hanging with him the whole way. He's able to just get his hand on the ball before it is handled by the Wolves receiver. Great defensive play. Hopefully that stand there by the defense will energize this offense and get the momentum back on the Chaos' side as we are at the 8:55 mark of the 2nd quarter. So the Chaos are going to line up here from their own 27-yard line with 1st and 10. They have 3 wideout set to the right. Man in motion, and it's a handoff to Johnson. And he's going to go up the middle for a short gain of about 2. So we're going to have a 2nd and 8 here from the 29-yard line.
Gain of 1, 2nd down and 9 for the Chaos.
The Chaos need to keep continuing to mix up their offense well and grind out these drives. They need to keep this Wolves defense on the field as long as they can and tire them out as best as they can. And that'll keep their defense well rested, especially after first half where we've seen the Chaos defense on the field quite a bit. And Shuchuk takes the snap. He looks right. And he finds number 19 on the right sideline. And he's able to lunge forward to the 40-yard line. So we're going to get a first down here for the Chaos.
That pass complete for a Chaos first down. 1st and 10 for the Chaos from their own 40-yard line.
And a great play call there by the Chaos, going with their big tight end, going with a big target, getting some space on the right side, getting them first down, building that momentum. Again, 1st and 10 here for the Chaos from their own 40-yard line. And once again, they're going to line up with 3 receivers out to the right. Let's see if they run a similar run play with Johnson here. They opt for the pass. Shuchuk rolls out to his right. Great block there by Johnson. He gets time for Shuchuk to toss it downfield to Brockman. He's going to go down the right sideline, and it looks like he's going to make it past the defense for a touchdown. Touchdown for the Chaos.
Touchdown.
A huge 60-yard pass by Mike Shuchuk to Matt Brockman. And there is a huge momentum swing for the Chaos as we are midway through the 2nd quarter. And you see there a great pass by Shuchuk. Underthrew him just a bit, but Brockman able to cut back to the ball brilliantly and evade the defenders of the Wolves and get into the end zone. Outstanding play there. And you see again that great block by Johnson, making that entire pass possible for Shuchuk. So it looks like the Chaos are getting ready to go for 2 here. So we have 3 receivers lined up to the left here for the 2-point conversion attempt. We have Shuchuk in the shotgun. Takes the snap, looks out to his left, and it is corralled in. So the 2-point conversion is good. So it looks like the score is going to be 20-8 here.
That brings the score to the Wolves 20, the Chaos 8.
Chaos looking to fight back here after a very rough first quarter, bringing the lead down to just 12 with 6:50 to go here in the first half. So as the Chaos get ready to kick off here to the Wolves, we'd like to see another great defensive stand by that defense. Again, the timeout earlier in the quarter by the Chaos seemed to have lit a fire under the Chaos as they're able to stop the Wolves' attack. And then they come back with an 80-yard drive for themselves, being capped off by a 60-yard pass to Matt Brockman. So we are starting to see the momentum swing back in the Chaos's favor. Hopefully they're able to carry it over again with another great defensive stand here. lines up the kick. And it's away. It looks like it's going to be fielded about the 6-yard line. So a great kickoff there. The Wolves look like they found a seam on the right end. And it's closed off quickly by the Chaos.
Kick returner takes the ball.
So the Wolves are going to start at about their own 30-yard line.
First and 10 for the Wolves.
So good coverage there by the Chaos. This is actually going to be worst starting field position of the day for the Wolves.
Oh, 30, okay.
Chaos make a quick switch just before the snap is off. The Wolves try to run the ball once again, and it's snuffed out
ball
quickly again
behind the line
by
of
the Chaos.
For a 4-yard loss.
And you can see here,
second
they try to
down,
make a last-minute substitution, and that does not stop
the
Chaos defensive line from barreling their way in and taking down the ball carrier. So they continue to do a great job of slowing down the Wolves' attack with the run game. The ball is dropped. That is an incomplete pass because it was a forward pass. So it's going to be 3rd and 14. So it really does look like the Chaos have the momentum swinging back in their favor here, as the Wolves are having a hard time reading this Chaos defense now. Snap is off on third down. The quarterback is looking left. He looks back to the right. They try to go for a deep ball down the right sideline, and it's overthrown.
The long pass is overthrown.
So it is going to be 4th and 14 here for the Wolves. Another great defensive stand. Two consecutive defensive stands here by the Chaos as they continue to try to fight back from that 20-0 deficit they put themselves in. There's a notable difference in the defensive line's energy here, as you see they're pressuring the quarterback much greater than they did the first couple drives of the half. The snap is away for the kick, and it is a good high punt here. No fair catch is called. The ball's fumbled, and the ball does roll out of bounds before the Wolves are able to pounce on it.
Punt return gets fumbled
out of
bounds.
So it is retained by the Chaos here.
At the Chaos 46-yard line.
They are going to have good field position here as they're going to start their own 46-yard line.
On their own 46-yard line.
One of the better field positions of the day. We're going to hope to see more of the same of what transpired on last drive, which was capped off by a 60-yard touchdown pass to Matt Brockman. The Chaos set up with two receivers on each side of the field, Johnson to Shuchuk's left. The snap's away. He drops back, and he's going over the middle of the field, and it's overthrown to the right side.
Shuchuk's
so it is going to be 2nd and 10 here
for the Chaos.
Down and 10 for the Chaos. After that big play there on the previous drive by Shuchuk, it looks like he's still having a hard time finding his consistency in his throws as he sails that ball nearly 10 yards over his receiver. We have 2nd and 10 here for the Chaos. They have three receivers lined up to the right. Shuchuk is once again in the shotgun. He takes the snap. He's looking left. He sees a receiver down the middle of the field, but he overthrows it once again. So that's going to bring up another third and long for the Chaos. Complete.
Third down and 10 for the Chaos from their own 46-yard line.
And you'll see here once again on the replay, good pressure by the Wolves, causing the hurried throw by Shuchuk, leading to this third long situation. So once again, we have a third and 10 here for the Chaos on their own 46-yard line with about 4 minutes left here in the half. They line up here with four receivers once again. And the rush is stuffed by the Chaos, and a throw over the middle of the field is complete. Looks like it might be just short of
Pass complete for an 8-yard gain.
It is going to be just short of a first down. So it is going to be fourth and short for the Chaos.
And two for the Chaos.
Looks like it's going to be fourth and two here for the Chaos. It looks like they are going to get ready to go for it. Once again, in that no man's land, they're deciding to go for the fourth down attempt. And there you go with another single back set here. They go for the run play with Johnson. He finds a seam on the left side. He breaks away from the defenders. A spin move, and he breaks through tacklers down to about the 32-yard line of the
Johnson
Wolves.
Johnson with a big run for a Chaos first down.
An outstanding run there by Johnson. A
first
big fourth down attempt there for the Chaos. And they're going to have a first and
Inside
10 from the 32 of
the
Wolves.
32.
A great play. You'll see him doing everything in his power to get through those defenders. Not only get a first down, but much, much more. And the Chaos seem to be finding that balance on offense. Another handoff to Johnson. He's patient enough, finds a seam in the middle of the trenches, and gets a short gain on the play.
And for a 4-yard gain, bring up second
bring
down
up second
and
six
for
here
the
for the Chaos. Just a minute and 56 left in the half.
Two-minute warning.
Mm-hmm. Looks like we have the two-minute warning here. A much better showing here in the second quarter for the Chaos. They have, ever since their timeout earlier in the quarter, their energy has been much brighter. Their offense has been a bit more in sync. Shuchuk has still been a little bit consistent with his passes, but all around a much better showing here in the second quarter for the Chaos. Their defense has been much better, shutting down the Wolves' attack twice in a row now. Looks like we're getting ready to come out of the two-minute warning here. The Chaos are going to line up three receivers to the right on their first and 10 play from the 28-yard line. I'm sorry, second and six from the 28-yard line. And it's going to be a false start on Matt Brockman on the right side of the field. There's a miscommunication on the snap count there as Brockman jumped before the snap was away.
False start brings up second down.
So that's going to move the Chaos back to the 33-yard line, so they where they'll have a second and 11 now.
From their own 33.
unfortunate miscommunication there that has seemed to be, that seemed to occur multiple times here for the Cavs as they run through the middle with Johnson, and it's going to get them a short gain of about two here. So it is going to be about a third and nine here. And the Cavs are going to call another timeout with just 1:20 left in the half.
3 yard gain on the play to the Wolves' 30 yard line. Third down and seven.
Once again, we'd like to thank all of you who are tuning in to the broadcast tonight. We are live from Benedictine University, where the Chaos are down against the Madison Wolves, 8-20. We've got a minute 20 here in the first half. Going to be a big third down here for the Chaos as they're looking to scratch out another score before the halftime here, as the Wolves will be getting the second half kickoff. So this would be a great opportunity for the Chaos to scratch closer to that Wolves, scratch, dig a little bit deeper in that lead. Four receivers out wide for the Chaos. Looks like there's going to be another penalty on the play.
Flags, no play.
And it's going to be another false start for the Chaos. So they are going to get moved back once again, and it's going to be a third and 13 now, making things that much more difficult for them to convert. So now be taking this third down play from the 35-yard line. Shuchuk takes the snap, throws it down the sideline towards Brockman, and it is out of bounds. He throws it a bit short of Brockman, and it's going to be fourth down now.
Intended for Brockman. Ball's incomplete. Brings up fourth and 13.
It's going to be fourth and 13 here
for the Chaos. For the Wolves, 35-yard line.
So I'm going to do a coach in 89.
So a couple of things to take away here from this first half. Defense has been much better for the Chaos as compared to the first quarter. They've defended the pass attack of the Wolves much better. The run defense has been outstanding so far. They haven't allowed anything on the ground against the Wolves. Once they find the rhythm on offense, anything is possible for the Chaos. Shuchuk's pass is thrown short to the left side, and it looks like it's another miscommunication by the Chaos.
For a turnover on downs.
So the Wolves are going to get the ball back with a minute 13 to go
first
in the half
ten
here.
For the Wolves from their own 35-yard line.
And they're going to get the ball at the 35-yard line. So there is still a chance that they can get another score here to broaden their lead before they get the kick in the second half. Other takeaways from this first half so far, the Chaos have been another good stop there on the run play by the defensive line, a short gain on the play. The Chaos have been victim to multiple miscommunications on both offense and defense. The second touchdown of the Wolves coming on a miscommunication in the secondary. Shuchuk has had multiple passes on the offensive end that have gone significantly wide. And there were a couple of times where the receiver has been flustered with the miscommunications. So it's going to be 2nd and 7 for the Wolves here from their own 38 with a minute left to go in the half. Chaos are looking like they're going to send 6 here on the play. But they drop back into coverage. It's another run play for the Wolves. And the Chaos hold them to another short gain as they're down at about the 40-yard line. Timeout called here by the Wolves with about 52 seconds left here in the half. It's going to be a 3rd and 5. Chaos doing an outstanding job once again there, stopping the run, not giving them any holes in the front 7 there. And it looks like we're ready to get back into the action here after the timeout by the Wolves. Line up with 4 receivers and a single back set. Chaos show blitz here. But again, they drop back into coverage, and it's a dump pass out to the running back on the left side, and he finds some space, and he's able to get to midfield. He's going to be down at the 49 of the Chaos here, so it's going to be another 1st down for
the Wolves. The run good for a 1st down into Chaos territory. 1st and 10 for the Wolves from the Chaos 49.
Time winding down here in the half. The Wolves seem to be in no rush here. Snap is taken. He looks right.
Can't talk right now, but it's over.
The ball is out into the middle. And they're able to find some space, but he's down at about the 25-yard line. And that's going to be halftime, folks. You're listening to Chicago Chaos versus the Madison Wolves on SportsTownChicago.com. So it looks like we're going to go to break soon here. During halftime, we're going to be hearing from our sideline reporter, Jen Liner. Great job of containing the ball carrier there by the Chaos to bring it to halftime. So we go to halftime here. Once again, the score is the Madison Wolves 20, the Chicago Chaos at 8. Once again, the Chaos struggling with miscues on the offense and defensive end. The defense has shored itself up here. We're going to send it down.
All right, good evening. We're at the 2nd half now. I'm standing with Coach Sam Odom. Did I say last name right? Good. All right, so it looks like the 1st half was a little rough. Defense was a little shaky, but you guys came back with the 2nd quarter, about 6 minutes to the end, with that touchdown by 89. How do you feel about the game?
Right now, it's not the way we want to go at all. Just little tweaks, adjustments. Just had to face some adversity. Okay. Came out throwing a little bit deeper, what we expected, but, you know, guys made plays. We just have to go back, look at, you know, what adjustments we have to make for the 2nd half, and we always do, and we'll come back.
Absolutely. Well, how do you plan on keeping the momentum going with the comeback? with the touchdown?
I just keep being aggressive. We came out real flat. Just got to keep being aggressive. Other than that, we know what to do with this team. We haven't given up 20 points in the first half, who knows how long. So
right.
So we'll just make the adjustments and just got to keep guys' heads up and everything, and we'll be fine.
Well, good luck to you, Coach Sam, and let's see what happens. All right. Thank you, guys. Back to you.
All righty. Thank you. Thank you, Jen. So you heard it there from the coach of the Chaos. They just needed to shore up the defense a bit, and they expect to be right back into this game. Okay, it looks like we're going to get ready to go to a break here. You're listening to Chicago Chaos Football on SportsTownChicago.com.
You could have spent your Saturday doing yard work, or cleaning the garage, or vegging out in front of the TV. But instead, you're covered in mud, jumping over fire, rocketing down a water slide with your friends, and just plain having fun. The chores can wait. Today, you're a rugged maniac.
Job in something I love. I want to have fun and meet new people. I want to be social.
The Illinois Media School has so many cool things they offer for me and their students.
With the amount of stuff you learn, there's no way you won't succeed. You'll learn how to do a voiceover, how to use camera equipment. I mean actual hands-on. You can even host your own radio or TV show. All of our instructors actually work in the industry too. So go to beonair.com and start your future in broadcasting today.
Quiero tener un trabajo en algo que me encante. Quiero divertirme y a la vez conocer muchas personas. El Illinois Media School tiene muchas cosas increíbles que ofrecer, no solo para mí, sino para todos sus estudiantes. Y con todas las cosas que aprendes, no hay manera de no ser exitoso. Aprenderás no solo a hacer segmentos de audio al aire y usar el equipo de cámara, incluso puedes tener tu propio show de radio o televisión. Y los instructores trabajan en la industria. Así que visita beonair.com y empieza tu carrera en broadcasting ya.
Yeah.
great. So I'm standing here with number 89, Brockman. He scored the touchdown in the second quarter. How are you feeling about tonight's game?
I'm feeling good. Slow start today, but I think we're coming back and making good moves. So I'm excited to see what this half has for us.
All right. And how do you plan on, you know, building the momentum up and getting some more points on the board?
It starts with our energy. Came out flat. So this half, we're coming out with the defense, hoping to make a big play and then come back on offense and put another touchdown in. So I think we're doing good.
All right. And what's your plan as far as scoring or, you know, putting some points up there?
Keep building my teammates up and have everybody keep making plays. And if it comes my way, then hope it gets on the board.
All right. Well, sounds good. Good luck, okay? All right. You're welcome. Pete, raise your hand up if you heard me. Did you guys hear me? Did you hear me?
Kids and teens are always on the run. They don't have time for this. That's why they need Pierce Footwear, the first laceless, tongueless performance shoe that's built for running fast, saving time, and looking cool. Forget the laces. Join the footwear revolution. Learn more about Pierce Footwear today.
The Illinois Center for Broadcasting is now the Illinois Media School. We've been an institution in the Chicagoland area now for 30 years. Because the broadcasting world is always changing, so are we. Not only are we teaching radio and television production, but now you can learn all aspects of the media industry, like web design. You can even specialize in TV or film, sports broadcasting, and even sales. No matter where you are in the Chicagoland area, we have a campus near you. The Illinois Media School. Be on TV, be on radio, beonair.com. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting is now the Illinois Media School. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting is now the Illinois Media School. We've been an institution in the Chicagoland area now for 30 years. Because the broadcasting world is always changing, so are we. Not only are we teaching radio and television production, but now you can learn all aspects of the media industry, like web design. You can even specialize in TV or film, sports broadcasting, and even sales. No matter where you are in the Chicagoland area, we have a campus near you. The Illinois Media School. Be on TV, be on radio, beonair.com.
Here at the Illinois Media School, we know you love sports. That's why we teamed up with the South Bend Cubs for our new Sports Emphasis program. You'll get to analyze games, do play-by-play, shoot, edit, and produce for the Cubs of the future, your South Bend Cubs. But you're going to have to hurry because there's only 6 openings left. For more information, go to beonair.com or call 630-916-1700. The Illinois Media School and the South Bend Cubs are a guaranteed W.
The Illinois Media School and the Chicago Cubs Single A affiliate in South Bend, Indiana are teaming up. Be a part of all the action with the Illinois Media School's new Sports Broadcasting Emphasis Program. You'll experience what it's really like in the broadcasting world by analyzing games.
Swing and a long drive to left field. Pickens on his horse, still on his horse. He looks up. Adios!
Play-by-play, producing, shooting, and editing games for the Cubs of the future, your South Bend Cubs. You'll be doing everything but handing out the peanuts.
Peanuts! Get your peanuts here!
The best part is you'll be covering up to 70 games this season and the opportunity to do play-by-play for the whole 9 innings. So start your career with a home run and join the Illinois Media School. For more information, go to beonair.com. That's beonair.com. The Illinois Media School and the Cubs. Now that's a winning combination.
You could have spent your Saturday doing yard work, or cleaning the garage, or vegging out in front of the TV. But instead, you're covered in mud, jumping over fire, rocketing down a water slide with your friends, and just plain having fun. The chores can wait. Today, you're a rugged maniac.
Kids and teens are always on the run. They don't have time for this. That's why they need Pierce Footwear, the first laceless, tongueless performance shoe that's built for running fast, saving time, and looking cool.
And we're back with the second half here at Benedictine University. A rough first half for the Chaos saw the Wolves jump out to an early 20-0 lead. Chaos able to regroup towards the middle of the second quarter and bring the game to 8-20. So with a 12-point deficit here, the Chaos are going to kick to the Wolves to start the second half. And the kick is away, and it's going to be fielded at the Wolves' 7-yard line. And it looks like they find the seam on the right side. They get up to about the 37-yard line. There is a flag on the play, however.
Kickoff return.
This one could be pulled about back quite a bit.
Yard line.
It looks like
the
official is signaling for a holding penalty on the Wolves. So it looks like this run will get pulled back a fair bit. So a fortunate start here for the Wolves.
Holding on the Wolves.
Fortunate start for the Chaos, I'm sorry.
We'll move the ball back. First and 10 for the Wolves.
So the Wolves getting sent all the way back to their own, inside their own 10-yard line.
First and 10 for the Wolves, deep inside their own territory from their own 10-yard line.
So a big break here for the Cats to start the second half. Let's see if the defense can carry the momentum they built in the second quarter here into the second half. It's a run here for the Wolves. And the running back unable to find space, but he is able to barrel ahead for a gain of about 3 on the play. Looks like the Cavs were lobbying for a turnover on the play. The referees are going to have the Wolves retain possession.
Second down and 8.
We have second down here for the Wolves from their own 12-yard line. They've got split receivers out on each end of the field. A snap. It's a screen play, but the ball is dropped. Referee signaling it was a forward pass, so it is going to be incomplete. And it's going to be third and long here
for the
Wolves.
From their own 12-yard line.
Defensive line continue to do a great job of hurrying and the Wolves quarterback and making him rush the throws, causing the incompletions.
Sorry, guys.
Doing a great job.
Second
Chaos was showing five. They go back into coverage, and the Wolves are able to find the seam in the defense on the left side of the field, and it's going to be a first down for the Wolves at around the 35-yard line.
First down to the 35-yard line of the Wolves. First and 10 for the Wolves.
You'll see here the quarterback of the Wolves able to get that throw off just in time as the pressure was coming from that Chaos front seven. Snap here, it's going to be a run play, and he finds the seam up the middle. He's carrying defenders all the way down to the 45 of the Chaos. So back-to-back big plays here for the Wolves.
Good for a Wolves first down.
An unfortunate turn of events here on this drive as the Chaos were looking like they were getting ready for another three and out. Quick snap here. There is a flag on the play. They go for a deep ball down the left sideline and defended well by the Chaos, so it would be second and long, barring this penalty here.
On the play.
And it looks like they're signaling a false start on the Wolves here. So it looks like that'll set them back a bit. As the referees sort this out, we'd like to thank our sponsors, Rugged Maniac. It's time to get rugged. Make sure to use the promo code CHAOS to get $10 off your next Rugged Maniac.
Illegal motion on the Wolves brings up first down and 15 yards.
So the ball is placed at midfield here for the Chaos. They're going to replay first down. The Chaos in pressure, and they stuff the running game of the Wolves. Outstanding push by the defensive line of the Chaos, and it's going to be second and long here for the Wolves.
Awesome three for the Wolves.
You'll see here this time they show pressure, but follow through on that pressure and get the big stop of the run game, and they continue to do well against that run game that has been normally very well for the Wolves. The Wolves drop back. He dumps it off to the running back on the right side. The running back finds some space, and he's able to get a gain of about 8 on the play. And it looks like the Wolves are back close to where the original line of scrimmage was on the 45.
For the Wolves, from
looks
the Chaos,
like
46.
The officials will line up at the 46, so it's going to be 3rd and 11, still 3rd and long for the Wolves. And we'll see if the Chaos are able to get that 3rd down stop that they need here to start the half. Chaos bring 4, pass out to the right. And a shoestring catch by the Wolves receiver. It looks like it will be just enough for a first down here for the Wolves. And you'll see here the linebacker for the Chaos gets caught off guard just a bit by the pass, and he's just late. Just late enough for that pass to get through. So the Wolves now have first down. At about the 33, they pitch it out to the left. Running back finds some space, pushes off the defender, and gets pushed out of bounds for a gain of about 5 on the play. Looks like the official lines it up at a 26 of the Chaos. So it's going to be a gain of 6 on the play. It's going to be 2nd and 4. Wolves looking like they're starting to find the rhythm once again in the passing game, as they're working well with using their check down. And the throw out right is incomplete. Slightly.
That pass is incomplete. Bring up 3rd down.
Throw is wide right.
And 4.
By the Wolves here. So it's going to be a 3rd and short for the Wolves. Uh, another third down here for the Wolves. It's the third down of the drive. We'll see if the Chaos are able to rally here and get that third down stop that they need to start the half. They bring the receiver in motion. They fake the sweep. The quarterback's scrambling right. He goes for the deep pass, and it's intercepted. They're bringing it down to the left side, and he stays in bounds. He's able to get just past the 30-yard line. Outstanding play by the Chaos. And that is the big play that the Chaos needed to start this half.
First and 10 for the Chaos.
And you see here number two of the defense able to rip the ball away from the Wolves receiver and head his way downfield. Outstanding play by the defense. Let's see if it'll spark something here in the offense, as they have struggled in the pass game so far in the first half. So 10:36 left in the third quarter here. First and 10 for the Chaos on their own 32-yard line after a big interception on the first defensive stand of the game. They start off with a run play. Running back barrels his way to about the 36-yard line. Nice gain of four on the first play of the drive. And first play of the second half here for the Chaos.
It's a four-yard gain. Second down and six.
You'll see here he's able to break away from the early pressure and push that pile just a bit to get that extra yard or so. And that brings us to second and six here from the 36. Shoot Chuck in the shotgun here. He's going to hand it off again. Running back is unable to find space. Barrels forward for a gain of about two on the play.
Third down and four.
So it's third and four for the Chaos here. We'll see what the Chaos decide to do here, as both the run game and the pass game are an open option with a shorter conversion attempt here on third down. Looks like they're going to line up four receivers, two on each end of the field. Shuchuk goes back for the pass, and it's an out route to the left side, and it's complete. So it's going to be a first down for the Chaos here at about the 45-yard line.
Out of bounds. First down, Chaos, from their own.
A big third down conversion here for the Chaos. And you'll see here on the replay, get a great out route here to the left. Great conversion for Shuchuk. That's a big confidence booster here to start the second half. Once again, the Chaos are lining up with four receivers. They bring a receiver in to help with the run block. And the running back's able to stumble his way forward for a gain of about three on the play.
3 yard gain on the play.
A good job here
down,
with the Chaos.
Seven.
Wearing down this Wolves defense, drawing out this drive, hoping to bring this game a little bit closer. They continue to tire out this Wolves defense. It may start opening things up in the passing game. Shuchuk takes the snap. He's in the shotgun. Looking right. He goes for the short slant route, and it's complete to Matt Brockman.
The pass complete to Brockman.
And he's going to be down at the 42-yard line of the Wolves. So it's going to be another first down here for the Chaos.
First and 10. Inside Wolves territory.
Good call here with the short slant routes. Outstanding job by Brockman to be able to hold onto that ball with the defender draped all over him. Another big conversion here by the Chaos as they continue to push their way down the field. So we have first and 10 from the 43 of the Wolves here. Shuchuk in the shotgun. He takes a snap. He's looking left. They bring the pressure. Shuchuk scrambling to the left. Flag down on the play, and Shuchuk barrels his way down to the 39-yard line. It's looking like it's going to be a hold, however, on the chaos, so it looks like this play is going to come back.
Flags on the play.
So it's looking like we're going to have to replay first down. It's going to be a first and long situation here for the chaos. Unfortunate turn events there as Shuchuk did an outstanding job of evading the pressure and making something out of nothing. So the penalty pushes the chaos all the way back to their own 48-yard line. So let's see if they can bring their second down conversion to a bit closer. So pass play out to the left. Deep ball by Shuchuk, and it's complete. Outstanding catch by completed. Number six of the chaos here. And it looks like they're going to be in the red zone
first
here of the Wolves.
The chaos from the Wolves, 11-yard line.
You'll see here Shuchuk getting plenty of time, throws a great deep ball here, and an outstanding job by number six of the chaos, keeping concentration on that ball between two defenders. You'll see here, Shuchuk starting to find his range a bit after a shaky first half, showing a couple of outstanding balls so far in this first drive of the second half. So we have first and 10 from the 11-yard line of the Wolves here. Just under 6 minutes left in the third quarter. Shuchuk takes a snap. Hands it off. And it looks like it's going to be a short gain of one on the play. Unable to find a hole there. Offensive line of the chaos unable to get the push they needed on that play. Again, despite some of the bigger plays in the passing game, the chaos are doing a good job of keeping a balance on offense, still trying to make a big play with the running game as well as the passing game. So Shuchuk takes a snap. He's looking right. He lobs the ball deep for Brockman on the right corner of the end zone, but it's overthrown.
Shuchuk's pass goes incomplete to Brockman.
So it is going to be third and long
and
here
for the chaos
from about the 11-yard line. Let's see here the throw. Well long there. Not giving Brockman much of a chance to corral that in for a touchdown. So third and long here for the chaos. You can only assume that the chaos are going to try to go for the end zone here on third down. This time the chaos bring three receivers out to the right of the field. The running back out to the left of Shuchuk. Brings a short pass out to the right. It's complete to the receiver, and it looks like he lunges in for the touchdown. Touchdown for the Chicago Chaos.
Touchdown Chaos.
And that's going to bring the lead down to just six here. Outstanding play call on third down, going with the out route to their big receiver out on the right end of the field. He's able to barrel his way over the defender and into the end zone. You'll see it here. Shuchuk watching him the whole way, finding plenty of space there, lowering the shoulder, getting over the defender and into the end zone. Great job there by the chaos, overcoming that hold penalty earlier in the drive and just marching down the field, letting the run game open up the pass game once again, and they're going to go for two once again. So Brockman in the shotgun, four receivers out wide. They're going to hand it off.
2-point conversion is no good.
And the running back tries to lunge for the goal line, but is unable to get it. So it looks like it's going to still be 14-20. The Cavs are down just one touchdown now after a great start to the second half.
Always on the run. They don't have time for this. That's why they need Pierce Footwear. The first laceless, tongueless performance shoe that's built for running fast, saving time, and looking cool. Forget the laces. Join the footwear revolution. Learn more about Pierce Footwear today. Kids and teens are always on the run. They don't have time.
And we're back here as the Chaos get ready for the kickoff. After a great drive, after an outstanding interception on the defensive end of the field. Defense once again sparking this offense of the Chaos. And the Chaos do an outstanding job of wearing down that Wolves defense. Using up quite a bit of clock here with just 4:20 left in the third quarter. They get set for the next kickoff. Cass gets set to kick it off. It's a short squib kick. It's going to bounce all the way to the 12 where it's going to be fielded. And great kick coverage this time by the Chaos as he's able to take down the ball carry at the 25.
Brought back to the 26-yard line, but there are flags.
There is a flag on the play. Let's see what the referees signal here. And it looks like they are signaling the penalty is going to be on the Wolves.
I see a lot because that's what I do, but I know there's they're not a big. I like it that way. Dogs that are popular are usually there's more garbage.
Oh yeah.
And it's going to be a face mask call on the Wolves, so that's going to set them back quite a bit here. Another unfortunate penalty by the Wolves. And the Chaos are going to look to reap the benefits of another miscue by the Wolves to start this second half. The penalty will set them back all the way, all the way to their own 14-yard line.
From their own 13-yard line.
Wolves look to run the ball. And Chaos finally able to take down the ball carrier at about the 15-16-yard line. Great resilience, though, by the Wolves back to keep barreling through defenders and getting those extra yardage. Looks like the Wolves are starting to mix up their offense a little bit more after their pass game has started to become a little bit flawed after they found a lot of holes in the defense in the first quarter. A miss throw by the quarterback of the Wolves, and it's nearly intercepted by the Chaos defense. You'll see there he tips off that he's looking left, and two Chaos defenders are there ready to defend the pass, and it's just tipped away. So third and long here for the Wolves. Looks like the Chaos are showing some pressure here, but they drop back into coverage. Great pressure by the Chaos. They bring the quarterback down on third down. Another huge play by this Chaos defense.
That's a Chaos sack.
Huge sack, big play once again by the Chaos defense as they continue to fuel this comeback.
From their own 11-yard line.
It is fourth and long now, and the Wolves will finally punt the ball, just their second punt of the game, but a great stand once again by this defense. Chaos hoping a great field position here with this punt. kick is away. Fairly good punt. It's going to drop at the 48, and he's going to pick it up and run with it. He finds a seam on the left side of the field, down the sideline. He brushes off a couple of defenders and gets all the way down to the 31-yard line. Late flags, though. We're going to have to see what the penalty is on the play.
To the Wolves' 31-yard line.
This could be another miscue by the Wolves. We'll see here what the referees come up with on the flag. And the penalty will be on the Wolves. So we'll see where they're going to be spotting the ball for the Chaos after another miscue by the Wolves. And you can see the momentum is really on the Chaos side at this point. Wolves getting very frustrated after fortunes have seemed to completely flip. So after the penalty, the Wolves are going to start this drive all the way at the 16-yard line of the Wolves. Shuchuk back in the shotgun. Running back to his right. They hand the ball off. He finds some space on the right side of the line, and he's going to carry the defender all the way inside the 10-yard line. And you can see the Chaos are fired up at this point after some great plays being made on the field. Now second down for the Wolves here. It's going to be spotted at about the 8-yard line of the Wolves. And time's ticking away here in the third quarter. Just 30 seconds left. As the Chaos are looking to tie this game up with another big touchdown. And this... The running back is through the line for a touchdown.
That's the Chaos touchdown.
Outstanding job by number 25 of the Chaos. Couple of great runs on that drive. He just sheds off the tacklers and is able to get into the end zone. You'll see a great lead block by the receiver number 6. Gives number 25 just enough room to shimmy into the end zone, and now it is a tie game, 20-20, just 19 seconds left here in the third quarter. And the Chaos are going to go for two here to see if they can take a 2-point lead with the end of the third quarter looming. Four receivers out wide. Shuchuk tries for a pass down the left sideline to Brockman. It does fall short.
The conversion is no good.
So it is a tie game here.
That brings us to a score of the Wolves 20, the Chaos 20.
And you see the ball is just wide of Brockman. Once again, the Chaos are finding a great balance in their offense. Pass game, opening up the scoring the first couple times around. But that last drive, they find great. The running backs finding great holes and making big plays, allowing for another score. And be sure to check out next week's game. The Chaos will be playing at Evergreen Park High School against the Illinois Cowboys at 7 p.m. on the 25th. And while the kick's getting set up here, we'd like to once again thank our sponsor, Lyle's Veterans Memorial. Their goal is to construct a memorial that honors our veterans while at the same time promotes civic pride. The memorial is to honor veterans that have served or are currently serving in any of the 5 branches of the military, including the Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines, and Coast Guard. So the Chaos getting set here to for the kickoff. Kicks away. This time they decide to go with a high kick, and it's fielded all the way back at the 3-yard line. Outstanding kick. But the Wolves finding some space on the left sideline, getting the ball all the way up to the 30.
Wolves return the kick to the 27-yard line. First and 10. You see here
another hole on the left side found by the Wolves return man. Becoming a common thing on theme on the special teams. And it does look like there is another flag on the play. We'll see what the officials deliberate with here. And it will be on the Chaos. So after multiple penalties on the Wolves, and the Chaos reaping the benefits of those penalties, the Wolves will look to capitalize on this miscue by the Chaos as they are going to start this drive on the 42-yard line now. And we'll see if the Wolves decide to start pushing the running game once again as their pass game has started to slow down quite a bit in the second half and after that interception near the end zone on their first drive. And he's going to dump it out once again to the left to the running back. He finds some holes in the middle of the field. He breaks a tackler, and he's down the field. He keeps shedding tacklers, and he's down all the way to the 20. And that's how we are going to end the third quarter here, folks. It's going to be first and 10 for the Wolves at the 20-yard line of the Chaos. Great third quarter, though, for the Chaos as they're able to come back and tie this game at 20. And you'll see there. So as we are coming to the fourth quarter, we are hoping to see more of the same here from the Chaos as they continue to build off that second quarter momentum that they had. And we're back here with the fourth quarter. Great third quarter again for the Chaos as they're able to tie this game up. We'll start with a pass play and a wheel route to the left, but the pass is dropped.
That pass, incomplete, brings up second down and 10.
Fortunate incompletion there for the Chaos as there was a miscommunication on the defense. You'll see they fake the wide receiver pitch, and the Chaos had to scramble to try and cover that pass, but fortunately it was dropped by the Wolves receiver. So this brings up second and 10 from about the 20-yard line. They go with a run play here, and again the Chaos are able to slow down that run game and keep it to a minimal game.
4-yard gain on the run. Third down and
so six. After 4 yards on the carry for the Wolves, it's going to be about third and 6. And we'll see if the Chaos are able to convert on another third down here. Chaos are showing 6 in the box here. They send 4. They're getting pressure on the quarterback. He flips it out to the right to the running back. They're able to bring him down close to the first down marker.
the pitch with a gain of 7.
It looks like they will mark it down at the 9-yard line.
First
so it will be enough for a first down for the Wolves. So it's going to be first and goal here. We have just 13 minutes and 30 seconds left in the game. This is a big moment here for that Chaos defense that has barked this comeback by the Chaos. See if they can hold it at goal here. Great stop once again on the run play. The defensive line of the Chaos holding strong throughout this game.
Drop for a 3-yard loss.
Time and time again, this defensive line has been shutting down this run game and makes another big play in a big moment of this game. Stuffing the ball carrier for a loss. So we have second and long here for the Wolves. Four receivers out wide. More pressure by the Chaos. They're able to dump it off to the left, but no gain as the Chaos are able to swarm onto the ball carrier.
Ball carrier once again brought down behind the line of scrimmage.
Another tackle for a loss by this defense.
Third down.
And they are
and 17.
Just doing an outstanding job
for
in this
Wolves.
Second half. You'll see the quarterback able to get the ball away before more pressure shows up. But the defense of the Chaos read the ball well. Three defenders came to take down the ball carrier. So we have third down. There is a flag on the play. And the Chaos are able to get to the quarterback, and he's down.
That's a sack.
A huge sack on third down.
There are flags.
He's down at the 22-yard line, but there is a flag on the play. And we'll see what the officials have to say here. Looks like it was encroachment on the offense, so it will be a decline. So it is now fourth down. It is fourth down from their own from the Chaos 22-yard line. And after the Wolves looked like they had finally solved this Chaos defense, the Chaos defense able to step up their game and keep sending the Wolves back. So the Wolves take a timeout here to deliberate and try to find an answer here at a pivotal moment in this game with just 12 minutes left. And while we're in a quick break of the action, we'd like to thank our sponsor, Lyle Wine Extravaganza. Wine aficionados will experience 10 one-ounce tastes of wine from a vast selection of over 80 different varieties of wine. There will also be craft beers to sample. The fest will feature live music from Tres Mustache and food from some local area restaurants. The Lyle Wine Extravaganza will be on June 18, 2016, 4 to 8 p.m. at Museums at Lyle Station Park. For more information, please visit www.lislechamber.com. So the Wolves, the snap goes wild on the field goal attempt. They try to get the ball away, and it's incomplete. So a miscue once again by the Wolves as the snap on the field goal cannot be fielded clean. You see here, the snap is just short.
No good.
The snap was short, and the field goal kicker can do nothing but try to throw the ball towards one of his receivers. And you can see there, the placeholder was unable to field that snap as it tipped off his finger and kept rolling back. So another great stand by that Chaos defense after the Wolves were able to get inside the 10-yard line. And now we will see if this Chaos offense can lead a big drive down the field to take over this game with 12 minutes left on the clock. They have plenty of time. Pass here from Shuchuk, and is dropped by Brockman at the 39-yard line.
Pass falls incomplete. Second down and 10.
Unfortunate here for Shuchuk, who's been having troubles with accuracy today. Gets a good ball into Brockman, and he's just not able to field it cleanly. So it's going to be second and 10 here for the Chaos from their own 22-yard line. Chuchuk in the shotgun getting ready for the snap. He hands it off. The running back finds a seam up the middle. He's able to carry a tackler with him all the way to the 30-yard line. So a big run there for the Chaos.
Gain
of about 7, so it brings it to 3rd and short here. That opens up tons of options here for the Chaos on 3rd down.
For the Chaos.
And they continued to keep that trend of balance in their offense. After the pass play didn't work, they switched to the running game and found an opening to get a nice play here. Four receivers out wide for the Chaos here on 3rd down. A big moment in this game. Snap is away. Chuchuk with the short pass over to Brockman, and it's complete. Brockman able to lunge his way over to about the 38-yard line.
Complete to Brockman.
Outstanding play there.
First down,
outstanding play call as well by the Chaos there, going with the short pass play on 3rd and short and converting. Doing a great job of simply moving the chains and not doing too much on that 3rd down play. If you guys are just joining us, a rough start by the Chaos had them down 0-20 early in the game. They're able to claw their way back with a great second half here. First down run play. Outstanding push by the running back. He leans his way all the way to the 46-yard line. So a nice run on first down is going to bring up second and short. Once again, giving the Chaos plenty of options here on what they want to do. The comeback of the Chaos being fueled by the defense. To start the second half, there was a big interception by the Chaos at the 2-yard line, which sparked their second touchdown of the game. And then earlier in this quarter, the defense downed inside their own 10-yard line, able to push the Wolves back and force a turnover on downs. So you see a screen here to number 6 on the second down. He's able to push his way forward, and he's going to be down, looks like, just short of the first down marker.
For a short game.
You'll see here another screen to number 6 of the Chaos. He does a great job of eluding a couple defenders and working his way forward as best he can.
And
they're going to be just short of a first down here on 3rd down. Less than a yard to go here on 3rd down. Chaos keep grinding away at that Wolves defense. Chaos once again going with four split receivers out wide. Chuchuk back deep. He takes the snap and he runs it himself, and he's going to get the first down.
Chuchuk with the
outstanding
keeper.
Run by the inside quarterback Wolves Mike territory. Chuchuk, and that's going to get them to the 46 of the Wolves here.
46-yard line.
You'll see here Chuchuk. No hesitation there. He finds that hole and he pushes through it to get the nice gain on 3rd down. And the Chaos continue to find the holes in the Wolves defense and keep converting on those big 3rd downs here as the time is winding down in the 4th. So 1st and 10 from the 46 of the Wolves. Chaos send 3 receivers out to the right. They bring back a receiver to the right of the quarterback for a run play. The rusher able to find some room on the right side, but is corralled down at about the 43-yard line.
Running for a short game. Second down from the Wolves' 42-yard line.
And it looks like they will mark it at about the 43. So second down coming up here for the Chaos. Finding some good success here with the run game in the second half of the game. Their last drive that led to a touchdown was fueled by a great run play. Chaos here setting up for second down. Snap is away. They look to pass. Short pass to the left side. Bobbled, but he hangs on to it. And it looks like he's going to be down at about the 35-yard line.
That pass is complete.
And it's going to be just enough for a first down for the Chaos.
First and 10 for the Chaos from the Wolves.
Another great job here by the Chaos. Finding great success with that out route multiple times in this game when they need some medium yardage on passing downs. You see once again, Shuchuk starting to find more of a rhythm here. And the receiver just able to corral before getting knocked down by the Wolves defender. So first and 10 from just outside the 35-yard line of the Wolves. 5.5 minutes remaining here. Chaos looking to take a lead after being down by 20 points in the first half. Shuchuk with time. He throws it out deep down the right sideline, and he's unable to hang on.
The long ball falls incomplete.
I agree 100% with the decision to go with deep ball here on first down.
For the Chaos. On the Wolves, 35.
Here, Shuchuk wanted to go right or to the left. Finds the receiver open down the right side. A great ball to get it past the defender, but the receiver just unable to hold on to the ball, and the ground, the impact of this fall is enough to jar the ball loose. So second and 10 coming up here for the Chaos. Once again, on the 35-yard line of the Wolves. They line up the running back to the right this time around. Shuchuk's looking left. Snap's delivered. Looks like they're going to hand the ball off. Johnson finds a seam down the right side. He's going to push his way all the way down to the 20-yard line. So that's going to be enough for another first down for the Chaos. And it looks like they are going to be in the red zone.
For the Chaos, first and 10 from the Wolves.
You'll see here Johnson, great vision. Shakes off the defender immediately and finds the hole. Great play there. Great decision by Shuchuk to hand the ball off. And Johnson able to get some speed down the field. And he's able to carry that defender a few extra yards to get them into the red zone here. First and 10 from the 20-yard line of the Wolves. Just 4 minutes remaining here in the game. Three receivers lined up right. Shuchuk looking right. Short out route, and the ball is just short. So it's going to be an incompletion here on first down. It's going to be first and 10. I apologize. Second and 10 here for the Chaos.
For the Chaos.
So we'll see here on 2nd and 10 if the Chaos decide to go back to the run game, which has carried them in the second half. Or if they will decide to go for a pass play on this down to get closer on third down. Snap here to Shuchuk. He looks right. He tries to dump it off to his running back, but it's tipped at the line of scrimmage by the Wolves. Wolves read that play well. And it looks like it's going to be 3rd and 10 here for the Chaos. You'll see here, Shuchuk tries to bait the defense with the fake look down the left side. Outstanding job by the defender of the Wolves to get up, read the pass, and deflect it. As Johnson did have some space down that right side. So 3rd and 10 here. Another big moment in this game. Just 3 minutes left. It's going to be 3rd and 10 from the 20-yard line of the Wolves. Chaos are looking once again to come back from a 20-point deficit. Snaps away. Shuchuk looking left. finds a receiver on the left sideline, and he stays in bounds, and it looks like he's going to have enough for the first down. Once again, the out route working very well for this Chaos offense, and they get 12 on the play, and it's going to be first and goal from the 8-yard line. You'll see here, Shuchuk eyeing number 6 all the way, seeing the separation, getting off a nice pass. The receiver doing a great job of getting looking upfield, finding the sideline, and getting out of bounds. So first and goal from the 8-yard line. Chaos looking to capitalize once again on the Wolves' miscues here in the second half, as multiple penalties have set them back quite a bit. And the Wolves are looking around flustered after they've let their 20-point lead fade away. Looks like the refs are deliberating here. And it looks like they're getting an adjustment on the clock here. And while we have a short break in the action, we'd like to thank all of you who have been tuning in to SportsTownChicago.com. We are live from Benedictine University, where the Chicago Chaos are looking to come back from a 20-point deficit that they suffered in the first half. It is first and 10 for the Chaos from the 8-yard line of the Wolves. There's 2:53 left to go here in the game. Chaos have made great adjustments so far since the first half. Their defense continued to make big plays when they needed it, and the offense has done a great job of keeping balance. The run game has been significantly better as well. So snap on first down. They're going to try to run it. The Wolves are able to read the run play well and stop it at the line of scrimmage. You see there's a breakdown in protection on the left side where that play was meant to be. So second and goal here for the Chaos. And they're going to send three receivers out right on this play. Brockman signaling right. He fakes the handoff, looks left. Reads the pressure well. He gets out to the right, shovels it to his running back, but he is taken down immediately by Wolves' defender, and he's able to get back to the 10-yard line. So a loss of one on the play. So it brings up third and long here for the Chaos. Now, although they are struggling to move the ball here in the red zone, they are looking to be in great position here with a minute 51 left on the clock. Even if they are unable to score a touchdown, they are definitely in field goal range, so there's a good chance they will be able to get some points out of this and take the lead with very little time on the clock. So with a timeout on the field, we'd like to take a moment and thank our sponsor, Rugged Maniac. It's time to get rugged. Make sure to use the promo code CHAOS to get $10 off your next Rugged Maniac. So we'll see what the Chaos draw up here on third down. We'll see if they'll try to set up for the end zone. It looks like, once again, they are going to send three receivers out to the right on this third down play. It Johnson's set to the left of Shuchuk here. Shuchuk in the shotgun. Shuchuk signals right. Takes the snap. He's looking right. He dumped it out to Johnson at the 12-yard line. He shakes a couple defenders, and he is going to be down at about the 4-yard line. Another timeout here by the Wolves, trying to keep as much time on the clock as possible. So you see here, great read by Shuchuk, realizing that there was no open receiver on the play. He finds the check down, gets good gain on the play. It's going to be fourth down at the 4-yard line. Should be lining up for a field goal here with just a minute 40 left in the game. Fourth down here, just a minute 40 to go. I can't imagine that this could be anything less than a field goal. As long as they're able to convert this field goal, though, they will take the 23-20 lead with very little time left on the clock for the Wolves to try and push for an equalizer. So the Chaos are breaking out of timeout, and it looks like they are lining up to go for the touchdown. This is a very risky play here by the Chaos on fourth down, just a minute 40 left to go in the game. Shuchuk looks right. He's lobbing it up for Brockman, and it is a touchdown!
Yes.
However, there is one flag on the play. We'll have to see what the officials decide on here.
Pass is good for a touchdown. There's a flag.
It's a holding on the defense. Penalties decline. It is going to be a touchdown for the Chaos. Outstanding play call. Gutsy play by the Chaos. Fourth and five from the 5-yard line. Shuchuk, outstanding ball. Great fade route into the corner from Brockman. You see Brockman able to get both feet inbound. Wonderful play by the Chaos. And that gives them a 26-20 lead over the Wolves, with just 1:33 left in the game. This has been an incredible comeback by the Chaos. They were down 20-0 early. The energy seemed low. And midway through the second quarter, Chaos called a timeout. And whatever the coaches said in that timeout, it lit a fire under this team. So for the two-point conversion, Shuchuk unable to complete it here. So it will be 26-20, Chaos lead.
20, the Chaos 26.
The Chaos defense, after that timeout in the second quarter, has done an outstanding job since then, not allowing the Wolves to score once since midway through the second quarter. Chaos morale is very high right now, and you see players going crazy after that last touchdown. The Wolves seeming a little lost at this point after giving up a 20-point lead. So now the Chaos leading for the first time in this game with just a minute and a half to go, getting ready for the kickoff. And you have to give credit to Mike Shuchuk, the quarterback. He's had an inconsistent afternoon. He's had quite a few missed throws, a couple of miscommunications on offense. But the Chaos were able to rally together and put together an outstanding drive here in the fourth quarter to get the lead. And once again, they did another great job once again of slowing the game down and tiring out that Wolves defense, using a lot of time, not giving the Wolves much time to get together a game-tying drive. Kicks away, it's a high, nice kick. Fielded at about the 13. It's bobbled by the kick returner. He tries to find a seam in the middle of the field, but the Chaos do a nice job of filling the gap and getting the ball carrier down just past the Wolves' own 30-yard line. So with a minute 18 to go, the Wolves are lined up to try and make a last-minute game-tying touchdown. Chaos signaling for last-second substitution. Looks like they're able to sort out their communication. The Wolves going for a deep ball on the first play, and it is completed. So an unfortunate turn of events here as the Wolves go back to the deep ball and find success once again, getting the ball all the way inside the 25 of the Chaos. So just under a minute left to go here in the fourth quarter. And the Chaos are going to call a timeout to regroup after the miscommunication on the deep ball. You'll see here, great ball thrown by the Wolves quarterback, just able to squeeze it in between the Chaos defenders. So with 58 seconds to go, it looks like the Wolves have some life after a deep ball brings them to the 24-yard line here, first and 10. Chaos are lining up with seven in the box here. Looks like they're showing six. They bring five. It's a bubble screen out to the right. Outstanding job of breaking tackles by the Wolves, and he's able to get about seven on the play. My apologies, six on the play. Wolves running out of time here. They opt not to use a timeout. Pressure by the Chaos. Unable to bring the quarterback down, and he's able to complete the pass. Brings the ball carrier down at about the 9-yard line. So with just 22 seconds left, the Wolves are looking for a last-second effort to try and tie this ball game. Looks like they're going to spot the ball at about the 9-yard line. Unfortunate play there for the Chaos as they had multiple linemen getting pressure on the quarterback, just unable to bring him down. And you'll see here, not one but two defensive linemen by the Chaos are unable to bring him down. And with the defender on his back, the quarterback of the Wolves is able to get that ball out. And you can tell he is not ready to give up this ball game yet as he's made two outstanding plays on this drive to keep the Wolves' hopes alive. So it looks like the officials have called a penalty on the Wolves, and that's going to set them back quite a bit here. It's going to set them back about 15 yards. They're back all the way to the 25-yard line. And they'll line up here with just over 20 seconds left in the ball game. The ball snaps off. They go for a ball in the end zone. And it's picked off by the Chaos. And they are going to say he was out of bounds. So no interception on the play, but a great defensive play by the corner of the Chaos. You see here, a good ball thrown by the Wolves quarterback, but just great defense by the corner as he was draped all over the receiver. So it's now third down here for the Wolves, 16 seconds on the clock, and they are surely going to be looking towards the end zone once again. They got four receivers out wide, running back to his left. Ball snapped. Great pressure once again by the Chaos, and it's a sack! Once again, the Chaos defense coming up with a huge play when it's needed.
And number sack for the Chaos.
Number seven of the defense has been the man centered around all of these big plays by the defense. That's his second sack of the game.
For the Wolves.
Biggest one coming right there, setting the Wolves all the way back to the 31-yard line with just 9 seconds left. So with fourth down coming up here, the Wolves are going to have one more chance at the end zone. And the Chaos are already celebrating on the field. This game is not quite over yet. So the teams are getting lined up here for a fourth down play, which could decide the game. Three receivers lined up to the right for the Wolves. Snaps short. They go for the end zone. Well defended by the Chaos, so it's intercepted in the end zone. Number two of the Chaos defense with his second interception of the game.
Picked up in the end zone.
As you can tell.
First down, Chaos.
And that's going to be just about it for this game. With 2 seconds left on the clock, Chaos now have the ball. They kneel down the ball, and that is going to be the game. An outstanding win for the Chicago Chaos, overcoming a 20-point deficit in the first half. Final score here is going to be 26 for the Chicago Chaos, 20 for the Madison Wolves. An outstanding win for the Chaos. This win will bring them up to 4-2 on the season. And that brings, and after this loss, that brings the Madison Wolves to 4-2 as well. So we're going to have a tie at the top of the NFC conference in the GFL.
Yeah, I'm going to protest because you suck at the time clock.
A huge win once again for the Chaos as their defense was the center of it all. Multiple big plays by number seven of the defense on the defensive line. Defensive line did a great job of putting pressure on the quarterback in the second half, causing missed throws, causing two interceptions by the end of it, and number two of the secondary getting both of those interceptions. Outstanding job all around by the Chaos to rally around each other and get a great team win.
I don't care what he says.
The biggest takeaway from this game, the Chaos's defense against the run was outstanding. Time and time again, they were able to stop the ball carrier with short gains, negative plays. So an outstanding job by that run defense. The defensive line stepped up immensely in the second half. And that's what led to the miscues by the Wolves, to the interceptions by the Chaos, and those interceptions leading to great long drives by the Chaos. They had two great drives of over 70 yards for two touchdowns, which tied the game and then later got them the lead with just a minute and a half to go. We also have to give credit to Chaos quarterback Mike Shuchuk. After a difficult first half with miscommunications and poor throws on the offensive end, he was able to bring it back in the second half. He read the defense much better, used his check down more, mixed it up with the run game, and he was able to make big throws when they needed it, including the fourth down go-ahead touchdown in the fourth quarter to Matt Brockman. And you see both teams now deliberating from their prayer after the game. Once again, this is Chicago Chaos Football, live from Benedictine University here on SportsTownChicago.com. The Chaos with a huge comeback victory, being 20 points down, rallying back after a rough first half to take the win, 26-20. And in just a moment, we are going to send it back down to Jen Liner on the sideline, who's going to be interviewing players after this great victory.
All right, guys, that is the end of the game. Chaos taking it 26-20 against the Wolves. I'm standing here with number two, our safety Mike, and number seven. How do you guys feel about the game tonight?
I feel good. You know, it's all about practice and competition. You know, just don't overthink the job.
Yeah, what a comeback. That second half was amazing. Third quarter, the defense was explosive. It really was.
Yeah, because, like, we was there first half, you know, and we need the energy from the sideline. From the stands, we get the energy from the sideline.
And what was the strategy as far as, you know, winning the game, getting those points on the board? What was the strategy you guys had?
Just stay focused and do your assignment. Just don't overthink. Do your assignment and follow your hands.
All right, well, thank you so much, number seven. And for you, Mike, how you feeling about winning this game? It was a big, big comeback. It really was.
Yeah, it feels good. I mean, we shut them out in the second half, which was good. I mean, I don't think we've ever been hit like that in the first half. I think we gave up, like, what, 20 points? So it's pretty impressive. But that front four that we have is pretty good. So
yeah, you guys played a great game, really did.
Thank you. And, like I said, special teams and defense did it again this week. So.
All right, well, good game, and I'll see you guys again, okay? All right, thank you. Back to you guys.
All right, thank you, Jen. So to reiterate what Jen was talking about, the front four of the Chaos was outstanding today. Nick White, Chevy Jenkins, Jamel Dudley, and Josh Arrington all played outstanding in leading this great comeback by the Chaos. All right, and looks like that's going to be it for us here from Benedictine University. Once again, the Chaos with a great comeback victory, 26-20. Thank you once again for tuning in to SportsTownChicago.com, and that's going to be it from us.